So we're just going to talk about zeros, this idea of zeros and how they show up on graphs, or don't show up on graphs. So last week we asked you to practice some stuff like this. Say that y equals that. And it's cubic, right? Third power. And it looks like it has these three zeros here, these three x-intercepts. So one's at negative one, one at two, and one at three. If I had gone through all my synthetic division work, I would know that this is equivalent to, since this is a zero at negative one, this would factor out to, it would have a factor of x plus one times, this is a positive two, so a factor of x minus two. Remember, we're saying like what value here makes this a zero? And then the third one is the positive three, so it would be x minus three. And you can see how those are the same. Same graph, they have the same zeros. So when we are in this form, we don't see those zeros regularly, but once we factor it, once we go through using that synthetic division tool to get it into this form, we can see those zeros readily. And again, x minus 3, it's a zero because if I plug 3 in to this, 3 minus 3 is 0, 0 times anything is 0, so that's when it outputs a zero. Now, some actually, this also has a y-intercept of 0, 6, this equation. So what's interesting to me about that is I could have the same zeros. I'm going to turn that off for a sec. I could have the same zeros and maybe multiply the whole thing by 2. So notice if I multiply this whole thing by 2, it stretches it by a factor 2 from that x-axis. I have the same zeros because if I plug them into here, I get 0 times 2. But what happens is my y-intercept changes because every other point changes because it gets stretched. So here it's at 0, 0,12. Remember it was at 0, 0,6 before that multiplier. So I could do that same thing here with this graph and show how it pops it up. So the intercepts are the x-intercepts and the zeros are fixed. We can see what they are from the factored form. But when I multiply by some value, it stretches it out, but still has the same zeros, but it changes all the other points. Cool. So that's when you can see all three of them. What if I had something that looks like this? X cubed minus 2x squared plus 9x minus 18. So if you look at that, wow, that's this weird, ugly, it's still cubic, but it only has that zero there that shows up. Now, if I were to factor this, this actually factors into x minus 2 times x squared plus 9. And we know how to deal with this. We could just solve it out or use quadratic formula or whatever. But what that means is I've got two other zeros here that aren't x-intercepts. They must be complex. So what would they be? Well, we know how to do that. We dealt with this last time. If I had like x squared plus 9 equals 0, I could use quadratic formula or I could subtract 9 from both sides, square root it. That's a negative 9 because I added 9 from both sides. Sorry. Square root that. Plus or minus comes in with it. Square root of 9 is 3. Square root of negative 1 is I. So my other zeros are plus or minus 3i. So there we go. Let me do one more that's kind of like this. So I'm going to have zeros at 5, 7, and negative 3. So if I have one at 5, I know I'll have to have an x minus 5. Or if I had one at 7, it would be an x minus 7. And if I had one at negative 3, it would be an x plus 3. And so notice there's my equation right there. If I wanted to write it in the x cubed plus blah 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 form, I would multiply this out. And I'm going to talk about that in another video.